Detecting and fixing memory leaks is crucial for maintaining an optimal performance and a smooth user experience. So, in this video, we will discuss what memory leak is and how we can detect them. Hi, I am Rohan, and this video is part of a series of videos where we are exploring how JS manages its memory in depth. So, let's get to it. As we know that our browser keeps objects in heap memory if they can be reached from a root through a reference chain. As a consequence, those objects that are not reachable are deallocated by the garbage collector after some time. So where exactly does a memory leak comes into the picture? And what exactly is a memory leak? A memory leak happens when an object in memory, which should have been removed during a garbage collection cycle, is retained in memory because it is accessible from a root due to an unintended reference through another object. Since these unnecessary objects are kept in memory, it can cause excessive memory consumption within the application, which can further result in inefficient and suboptimal performance. How exactly do we figure out if we have a memory leak in our code? Well, memory leaks are often sneaky and difficult to notice and localize. The leaking JavaScript code is not in any way considered invalid, and the browser will not throw any error while we are running it. If we notice that our page's performance is progressively getting worse, then the browser's built-in tools can help us determine if there is a memory leak in our code and what's the cause of it. Developer tools offers us much more advanced ways to manage and visualize our memory usage. So, suppose we have our app open in a browser tab. Let's say Chrome in our case. So, right-click, click on Inspect, and go to the Performance tab. Start recording the page by clicking on the record icon. In the meanwhile, we will perform some action in the page, like clicking a button or scrolling, or we already have a timer doing some task, and then stop the recording after a few seconds. We can see the CPU consumption and the net heap chart over this recorded period. This will give us a rough estimation of whether or not we have issues in our code. For example, too much CPU usage in our page, which will show up as red lines all over the chart. Or we can study the net heap chart to roughly figure out if there is a memory leak in our code. If there is a memory leak, then the chart will generally show us these two patterns. The first one is easy to understand, since it shows more and more memory usage over the recorded period. Now, I am not saying that the chart will always look like this. There may be some dip somewhere in the chart, but the memory usage will overall be going up. The second chart, however, may or may not be a memory leak. It can be the expected behavior, but it's more often than not a clear indication of a memory leak. The chart generally means a sharp increase in the memory usage, then maybe a garbage collection cycle which frees up some memory, and then again after some time, increase in the memory usage, and so on in a cycle. When we have situations like this, it's best if we utilize the memory tab too. Let's go to the memory tab. In this, we can select the heap snapshot, which will help us take snapshots of the heap over a recorded period in which we are performing some actions in the page or in which the page is running some tasks or micro tasks. So, let's say we record a few snapshots of the heap by clicking on the record icon while we are clicking on the button in the page. If we select one of the snapshots, we can check if some of the objects are taking up too much memory, or if we select objects that are being allocated between snapshots, then we can check if some of the objects are being created while we are performing some actions on our page. There are several ways we can utilize these tools. So, to quickly summarize, we discussed what memory leak is and how we can detect them in our code using developer tools in our browser. Examining memory usage via tools is all well and good, but it's useless if we cannot find out where exactly in our code there are memory leaks. So, in upcoming videos, we will take a look at a few different use cases that are the common causes of memory leaks. We will understand them so we can avoid using these types of coding patterns. If you like this video, consider liking and subscribing. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Namaskar.